That's right, the boys are back in town, and the Alternative Commentary Collective is back on Spark Sport for all Black Caps home matches this summer. Download the Spark Sport app or sign up at sparksport.co.nz to stream every home Black Caps match with ACC commentary today.
Fan of the Hauraki Big Show podcast? Make sure you check out more from Jace, Mike and Keezy on their Instagram and TikTok at Hauraki Big Show, or tune in to them 4 to 7 every weekday on Radio Hauraki. Thanks, mate.
So I'm at the petrol station on the way here, getting some petrol.
Oh, yeah. Not any durries?
No durries. Tempting, man. Tempting.
Good on you.
But you see, I can't get away with it because my wife smells it on me immediately.
Oh, yeah.
Mind you, to be fair to her, she doesn't actually give a fuck. She's like, nah, she would be like, okay, that's fine if you want to smoke. She doesn't really care. Which actually, I needed to be more staunch about it.
Yeah.
And say, actually, no, you shouldn't. You've done so well.
No, well, actually, I actually find it better with my, because my wife's the same. I think this time around she'd be a bit pissy because it's been a year and a half.
Yeah.
But I preferred it that she didn't make a big deal about it, because that's when it was like, I'm kind of letting her down. It's like,
yeah.
You know, she's like, but yeah, I think if I was getting nagged about it, I'd probably dig my heels in a bit.
So I'm at the pump, right, and there's this woman next to me. I'd say late 60s.
Loving it.
A real Westie.
Oh, sure.
Right.
Can I describe her as someone, when I looked at her, who's lived a life?
Oh, yeah, she is rugged as fuck.
A hard fucking life.
Right.
So when I say she was like late 60s, possibly 40.
Yeah, sure.
But right, had hit the durries and whatever. She was standing holding the petrol pump, screaming at the top of her voice, "Your fucking pump's not working! Your fucking pump's not working!" And the dude is in the petrol station on the intercom going, "Hang it up in the cradle and then take it out again. Hang it up in the cradle and then take it out again." And she stood there holding it the whole time going, "You fucking assholes! Your pump's not fucking working!"
She didn't hang it up in the cradle, did she?
She didn't put it back in the cradle. No. I don't know about you guys. If someone's calling me an effing a-hole, yeah, I'm not inclined to go and help you.
I agree.
You know what
I'd
I mean?
Be telling you to put it back in the cradle.
And seriously, I got petrol, went in, paid for my petrol, came out, she was still going. And the guy behind the counter was just standing there going, "Jesus Christ."
Yeah.
That seems like it's not about petrol.
What a job, eh? Dealing with the general public like that.
Did you put her away?
I thought about the douche.
Oh, different kind of put her away.
What did you mean?
Oh, you mean have sexual intercourse with her.
Oh, jeez. That's not all, man.
That's not cool.
Sorry, man.
Jesus.
I mean, if I was going through a really rough time, maybe, and I was single.
Yeah.
You know,
well, if you needed somewhere to live.
And I needed somewhere to live, and I was on it, and I was smoking the durries, and I was on the pipe, and I was on the needle. Yeah, I'd probably go there.
Is that all it takes?
You know what I mean? That's all it would take, Pugs.
Damn.
You sent a photo in our group chat today.
Last night.
Oh, last night.
Late last night. Yeah. I was thinking about you guys late at night.
Late last night.
Who is that? And it was you, Pugs.
Without a hat on.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I went, jeez, I didn't recognise you, mate.
I'll get there.
Here he is.
Just in an awkward grow-out phase, so I'm really leaning into the hats.
Right.
Yeah.
I thought the hair looked fine in the photo.
Oh, you
didn't say anything, so I didn't really know.
Oh, look, I mean,
it was 11:30 at night, to be fair.
You look great, and you know, I just didn't quite recognise you initially. You know what I mean? Yeah. Did you take a quarter last night, Minogue?
I did, actually.
Better?
No, I'm rooted again today. I'm assuming it's, but also I woke up fine.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think I'll give it a miss, and we'll see how I'm feeling tomorrow.
Okay.
I had 3 bottles of rosé, though.
Yeah, that might have something to do with it.
Nah. Sounds like it's your quarter of a pill, I reckon.
How many durries?
No durries.
Oh, just the vape.
Just suck on a vape.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
Jeez.
Yeah. Do we have any jokes come through there, Pugaroo?
We do.
Oh, do we?
Well, we've got an advice question.
We do have an advice question.
I'm just wondering about the jokes, though, because we haven't had any jokes for a while.
Yeah, there was one that I found, and I did not put it in there, which I'm now regretting. Hello. Ah, here we go. Hey, boys. I was wondering why music was coming from my printer. Turns out the paper was jamming.
Any others there, Pugs?
That was the extent of my search. Well, I'll see if there's any more.
That's all right. We'll get into the advice question.
Yeah.
Well, I actually had somebody that sent me a joke.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Fells?
Is it a bit off colour?
I don't know if you can say that. Let's just pretend I'm not saying it. Well, actually, this is from a woman. This is from a woman, so I think that makes it okay.
Oh.
Renee, her name is. What's the difference between a testosterone? Oh, what's the difference between a testosterone and a hormone?
What?
You can't hear a testosterone, but you can hear a.
Oh, fucking hell!
Was that last line actually part of it? Where you
explained? No, I added
that. Yeah,
yeah.
Oh,
okay,
that helped you though, didn't it? I saw it become clear for you.
Yeah.
So that one's probably winning this week.
Yeah, so far.
Now this is for, we're doing the bug assault gun this week as well. That's the outro prize.
Oh yes,
which
yes,
be good.
And
some
and
BK
and all that sort of stuff. Yeah. Great stuff. Hey guys.
Hey.
So me and two mates have been looking for a flat here in Wellington, and it's a complete
shit show.
My lease ends in a month, and we still haven't found anything. One of the mates who I'm looking with currently lives with his parents. He's 24, so he's been very picky slash bit of a princess in terms of the kind of place he wants to live in, and he doesn't have a lease that's about to end. I just simply want to find a fucking place to live. Is he a wanker? What should I do? Cheers, Jarman.
Jarman?
Jarman. That's what the printer was doing.
Is he a wanker? Yeah, well, I can understand that side of it. You don't want to live in a shithole, but also if you're sort of ticking along nicely.
Sort of what happens when you choose to live with people that are in different situations. And some people are in a rush, whereas some people have the time to be more fussy about it.
Well, I'm just trying to think, when I was 24, actually, I was in my current relationship then. So that was a bit different. But, you know, in my late teens, early 20s, didn't really give a shit about what the flat was like. A little bit, but not massively. Like, we had one flat where literally the kitchen was falling off the house. You know, you don't give a shit about that.
I lived in one with my brother, and sort of backed onto the old railway tracks there. And there it was, the house was so on the piss, like the poles were so out, that when you sat in the bath, your legs were covered in water, but your ass was completely dry. That's how fucking shit it was.
And you see, at that age, you think that's kind of cool.
Yeah,
you know,
a bit
I mean?
Of character.
Well,
yeah,
I thought it was good because it meant that I didn't have to worry about it. It's like, don't look, oh, you got to look after the house and not look out for the carpet. Don't put your drink there or any of that. It didn't mean shit to me.
And then we went from that place, me and my mates, because we all sort of stayed together when we were looking for flats. And we found this place in Remuera that was mint. It had like 5 bedrooms, an amazing garden, 2 lounges, a beautiful oak kitchen, like with oak everywhere. And it was just next level. And they let 5 fucking druggy dropkicks go and live there for a year
and a half.
That's
the one where you didn't pay for the power.
That's the one where we didn't pay. Exactly.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. But even then, I mean, when you're that age, you don't really give a shit as long as you've got a bed and a roof over your head, because you're on it most of the time.
I think what I'd do is I'd just say, well, if we haven't got anywhere to go, then I'll move in with your parents.
Mm.
That's the only fair way to go. But I would just start looking, and your mate can get fucked. And in fact, I'd actually just cut it down. I'd just only look for me and the other guy.
Yeah.
What do you think about this one? I don't like it. Okay, well, we're not going to.
Well, we're going to take it. Yeah. We're going to take it. So you're either with us or you're not with us. Yeah, good call, man.
Yeah,
but I do feel for the young people out there. She's a fucking shit fight getting a flat.
So bad.
My daughters are like that too. It's like, Christ, I can't believe what they pay.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Mm. Yeah.
$250 for a shitty little room, and then you got your bills on top.
Are you joking?
It's madness.
I can't believe it.
It's madness.
It's crazy.
Yeah, so, Jarman, just say, look, we're taking this. If you don't like it, piss off. All right?
Okay.
And he is he a wanker? Answer to that one?
Yes.
He is? Cool.
Yeah.
Good shout.
Yeah, it's tough as well. A month ago, you're dreaming, man.
Yeah.
You're dreaming. Oh, it's a shame, eh?
Yeah, well,
poor old Jarman.
You probably ended up, you know, if you did live with him, you probably ended up hating him anyway.
Jarman?
Yeah, he sounds like he's
quite... No, Jarman would end up hating the other guy because he'd probably be one of those really neat freaks as well.
Hey, guys, can we keep an eye on our dishes, please?
And one of those guys that wants to have flat meetings all the time.
Oh.
You know what I mean? Flat meeting!
I
really upset you left your pubic hair all over the bar. You know, it's like, oh, fuck off with your flat meeting. You and your fucking flat meetings.
You and your pubes, you prick.
You know what it's like, though, eh? With fucking, there's always one in the flat that wants to have flat meetings. Mm. You know what I mean? And air their grievances for about 4 hours.
I've lived with multiple people who have hit everybody else up about dishes while also not doing their dishes.
Yeah.
It's the same shit.
Food. Or eating their food. I mean, what's so bad about eating other people's food?
Exactly, man. We're doing you a favour, man.
What's so bad about urinating on your flatmate's television because you're steamed?
What's so bad about... You were talking about this off air about hooking up with all your flatmates' girlfriends.
Totes, man. Totes. That's quite a few of the flat meetings were actually about.
Yeah. Hey, right. Old Hoddy J. Yeah, could you?
Just going around the flat having a bit of a root session. Yeah.
Could you?
Hey, keep those questions coming in, by the way, and we need more jokes.
And
so
jokes.
Send them to our Insta page,
totally.
And Pugs will get on them and we'll deliver them.
Keezy word?
Inevitable style, yes.
Your Hauraki Big Show Keezy Word of the Day is...
flatmate.
Seems easy to remember. What was the one yesterday? That was the name of the sleeping...
Quetiapin.
People struggling with that one.
I was struggling with that.
Like you say, though, I'm actually really looking forward to seeing how they spell it.
Yeah.
Or unless they probably Google it, you know, because they don't want to look like deer brains.
Yeah, true.
You know
no
I mean?
Googling.
Just
no Googling.
Spell it off
Raw
the top of
it.
Your head.
Mm.
Yeah, beautiful.
Surgeons keep our hearts beating. They do the amazing, help save lives, and so can you. Your CSL plasma donation can help create 24 critical life-saving medicines that can give grandpa the chance for his heart to swell when he meets his new grandson, or give a bride the chance for her heart to skip a beat on her wedding day. Every plasma donation helps more than you know. Do the amazing. Help save lives. Donate today at your local CSL plasma center and be rewarded for your generosity.